Bobby Robson's team in front of Peter Shilton includes two Evertonians who emerged during the... Bobby Robson's team in front of Peter Shilton includes two Evertonians who emerged from the close season tour of South America, Gary Stevens and Peter Reid, and three players who were among the substitutes when England went to Bucharest last May, Glenn Hoddle, Gary Lineker and Chris Waddle. There are nine, in fact, who played against West Germany in the last really competitive match. For me, it's a side of adventure and promising balance. In the end, the Romanian lineup shows only one change from the team which started against England in Bucharest. Jovan comes in, he was a substitute then for Iorgulescu and keeps the place with Iorgulescu on the injured list. He's been debating for a long time, the Romanian coach. In the end goes the taller of his two goalkeepers and decides to leave out one of the more progressive midfield players, Mateuts. Karl-Heinz Tritschler of West Germany is the referee. He has two linesmen from his country. Well, David Gower and his men gave breath to a drowning English summer. And now, on the sort of evening that we so missed in July and August, the firm of Robson & Robson had the chance to warm the coming winter with thoughts of a Mexican sun. England in white, attacking the goal to our right. Romanians in the end deciding to play in red, although this time last evening they'd agreed to play in yellow. They have quite a few problems with some of their own making, but they'll be pleased that Bellonet, the number 10, is fit for them. He was their major doubt. Here's the captain, Stefanescu. Gary Stevens, who's taken over the number 2 shirt, making his home international debut. Here's Bellonet. Peter Shilton, the most often selected by Bobby Robson, 31 times out of tonight, a 36 match. It's Korash, who missed a real chance, the best chance in Bucharest. Mark Wright. Peter Reid. Over from Ray Wilkins, whom he displaced when Wilkins had to go home to play in the Italian Cup, home that is in football terms. Lineker and Goriano stayed away from him. Stevens, and it will come as no surprise to you, I'm sure, if I note that every Romanian is quickly behind the ball. not to lose here must be their main priority. Here's Chris Waddle. Two men to stop him. Waddle. The turn beat the marker. And the marker flattened the turner. And the flattener was Klein. Hately up on the near side as we look. And the choice of Lung in goal was much because of the height of Hately and his power in the air. And Lung comes way off his line to get the fist. He seemed to hurt his elbow as he fisted the ball away. It is taken over from Moraru, who played in the last match against Finland. Huddle beats Koresh. Bellinet. Mark Wright. And a sloppy ball by him. Koresh. Lack of concentration by the Southampton centre-half. Klein. Covered the man in the middle, who was Hadji. Reid. Well, England have been slow starters in recent seasons in the opening international. Lineker, it's so important for them, they can start well tonight. Robson deciding to test it for others. But he was certainly in the front line. Hately. Chase for Lineker. Good support from the crowd. Although sad to say they, or at least some of them, declined to follow the request in the programme by manager and all concerned that they should not whistle or boo the opposition's national anthem. Terry Fenwick. It's a chance because of the injury to Terry Butcher. Reid. Huddle and Robson both well forward. Reid filling the hole behind them. And Lineker looking for the holes up front. Gurianu plays at left back. Here he is. Where's number four? Basically a right-footed player. Here's Huddle, which is his better foot. And the whistle goes for foot up. Direct free kick. And Huddle, who surely showed in South America that he's the sort of player needed there, able to change the pace of the game. Lung, there's three forward. Waddle in the defensive position with Neglia. Fenwick. Played alongside Mark Wright just once before when he came on as a substitute when they both made their debut back in May 84 against Wales. A match that was lost, incidentally. Wright. Long legs. Was he caught? Yes, he was. Klein the aggressive again, and that's very much part of his play. Finnick. And a bit of holding by Lineker. Stop your van coming through. Here's Hadji. First time he's really been in possession. Well, that's not a bad try! And it came back off the crossbar. Well, that's the measure of this 20-year-old. He was a full 20 yards out. Shilton may have just brushed it with his fist. Hadji again. Stefanescu. A shot from the defender, not quite matching that of the forward. And Peter Shilton, happy that he still has a clean sheet. And how well it was struck. It backed off him a bit, left foot shot, it was curling. And it came off the crossbar, and I don't think Shilton did touch it at all. Reed. Right. Heathley. Just away from the head of Hoddle. Guriano. Fenwick. Sansom. Looking for and finding Hateley, but it was something of a standing jump by Hateley. Didn't come in on the ball at all. Hateley. Just taken away from him. Say that Peter Reid wants to get involved is one of the understatements of the season so far. Bit too long. Brian Robson prepared to chase. Peter Reid so much has come his way since he signed for Everton in December 82. Cup and League, Cup Winners' Cup, Players' Football of the Year, and now World Cup debut. The first 10 minutes, typical of the pattern we'll probably see throughout. England with a great deal of possession, doing most of the attacking. One scare. Sansom. Hateley. He's a useful forward when he wants to be. By the referee to let play continue. Hateley's got away that time slightly. Waddle hasn't really gotten into the match yet. But that's a free kick. And Hateley moving across the 18-yard area. And stride for stride with him goes Silvio Jovan. Ball went the other way. Down the middle, Korash this way. This is Rednik, number 5. Hadji. Huddle needs somebody going right side. Hayton is going there, so he switches it the other way. What a marvellous ball. Lineker the receiver, followed over there by Unguriano. first Wantras of many. Plenty of room for Mikhail Klein. Plays for Corbin Yule. Lucescu, the national coach now, started his coaching and managerial career. Bellonet, Courage, Stefanescu fencing his chances, and he's got a better left foot than right. Possession. It's Peter Shilton who's had the greater alarms. Fingers burned a bit then by Stefanescu. And the woodwork must be still feeling the curler from Hadji. Bellonek. Stefanescu. One of the senior members of the side, Stefanescu, now 34. Against us in the previous World Cup qualifying matches. We've got three up. And here's Klein. Koresh. Kamataru. Well, they're making much more out of a great deal less. And they're not frightened to have a go. Which is perhaps a little unusual for an Iron Curtain countryside. No hesitation at all from Kamataru. Bellonet. Reed. Lineker and Haitley forward. A long run for Gary Stevens. Hadji who covered the run. First time we've seen Gary Stevens get forward. Did so effectively in Mexico. He thought he was pushed. Redknapp, good strong challenge by Fenwick. Brian Robson. Hoddle. Stevens. They're bunching a bit, they want a bit of width somewhere. Good play by Kenny Sanson. Reed. Side against Brian Robson, although the referee allows play to continue. England's best attack so far have been started by Kenny Sanson. Koresh. Huddle. Nice sway. But his pass to Waddle lacked accuracy. Quick hit against Koresh. And the referee, I think, is going to show the yellow. Yes, he does. Yellow card to Kourash. He plays for Sportu. Lovely description of that challenge. England substitutes, warming up, Ray Wilkins and Gary Bailey. John Barnes as well. Fred Street. There's Error with the remedy. Waddle had come back to collect. Did a lot of twisting and turning. Got away from one. Here comes Kourash. And he caught him on the instep, or possibly up on the anchor. Bobby Robertson, not exactly looking the life and soul of the party at the moment. England's need is the greater, and as a result, they're tending to be slightly over keen. A goal by Romania would be a bonus for them, and they seem to be finding more time when they do attack. All the photographers around the Romanian goal, at least about 85% of them. Waddle lets it go. Hoddle for the chip up. Offside given. Won't count. Offside against Haitley in the middle. Nicely worked free kick with Terry Fenwick getting on the end of it. But look for the man in the middle. Intricacy here. Hoddle who crossed it. But it's Haitley there. He's the one who's offside. He went too soon. Fenwick did not. But the referee had his whistle to his lips before Fenwick made contact. Pity, because it deserved a goal, and it was wiped out because of a little bit of impetuosity. Fine. Waddle. Reed. Waddle really gave Reed something of a blind pass, because Waddle could see that was a challenge coming in. Rednick let the ball do the work for him. Stefanescu. Kamataru. Aguila. And the disallowed goal has certainly lifted the crowd. Down there. Right. Huddle. Stevens. Lineker being followed everywhere by Ungureanu, but how will he beat him? Waddle. I'm sorry. Nicely done. Stevens. I think maybe Chris Waddle has got to make up his mind a little more quickly, because running at people is all right if you're going at pace, but if you're slowly going at them, it simply gives the opportunity for defenders to cover space and players. He gets a corner out of it, for which Mark Wright has come onto the near post. And Wright got a bit of it, but not for long. Oh, that was a little old-fashioned, but made to look so by Lung's lunge. Taru, long ball cut out two for a moment. Peter Shilton, as usual, offering advice. Stefanescu, the man at the back covering. recovery. Slightly awkward. Lineker has Nagula for company this time. Jovan with Haitley. That has never changed, that particular opposition. Halfway through the first half. A match which, if England can win, we'll see them into Mexico. Klein. Reed pushing him towards the touchline, forcing the turn. Fennec, good strong challenge again. Haji. Prepared to have a crank from any sort of range. Waddle. And Gurianu. Veronique covering behind the number four. That's well used. Sansa. Robson. Reed. Offside. Push by Jovan. Haitley is number 9, Waddle number 11, Lineker number 10. Robson has joined them. Huddle is onside! 1-0! Oh, that's lovely! Really gorgeous goal, because the Romanians were looking the other way and suddenly the barn door behind them was wide open. Look at this, they're all looking for the long ball. They move up. Abel just stayed onside because of the defenders on the near side as we looked. And that's his 7th goal for England. Comes in the 25th minute of this particular World Cup contest. First time, incidentally, he's played in the World Cup since the game against Kuwait in Bilbao, which for me is utter nonsense, but never mind. But a beautifully worked free kick. And the Romanians fell for it, hook, line and sinker. And settle down. Temper eagerness with court. Haitley made his presence felt then by doing precisely nothing except going to stand by the far post. Seen yet from Chris Waddle. Lovely swerve which took him outside his man and created the space. Quickly unable to add the finishing touch. And the move started by a complete switch of the angle of play by the man in the centre there. Ben Hoddle. Porash. For company. Haitley. Adela. Chris Waddle beginning to make his presence felt. He's free to pull it back to, and he wins the corner. Sanson doing his defensive chore again. Rather more forward than previously. Thought he'd been fouled, but hadn't. He's one of the Dynamo Bucharest players on the side. Up for whom Mircea Lucescu, the coach, played so well. Lucescu played against us in 1970. England beat Romania 1-0. And Guadalajara. Goal scored by Jeff Hurst. With Lucescu, two from the left as we look. Oh, well collected by Reid. That was intended, it was brilliant. Robson. Reid, still possibilities. Plenty of players in the area. Was not a good one. And the foul by Stevens. Hadji. Koresh. Imatari wasn't quite there. Good defending by Stevens. Waddle is onside, and Lungs had to come all the way out. He didn't frankly look as though he would be too much of a player in five sides. Didn't look very happy to play that, but the Romanians had moved right the way up onto the halfway line. Surely enough pace in the England side to beat an offside trap. Hate it. Hadji, Rednik has gone on, certainly been more forward since Romania went behind. Hadji, three in the box again. Koresh disappointed. Koresh was the player who missed the header when Mark Wright slipped in Bucharest. Could have made a big difference to the whole group. Huddle. Matario doing a lot of running. Not often in receipt of the ball. Brian Robson. Reed. Stevens forward on the right. Linnick has come away from his defender. Hately pulling away to the far left. Top of the pitch is Wheeler. Waddle. Well, the idea was very good. Just a little too long. Beaten to it by Stefanescu. Variation again. That's a teaser. Came off right. And I must say, it is very refreshing to see England playing a lot of thinking football. The corner was different from what the Romanians were expecting. That was a delightful cross. The header was by Wright. And when you consider the last 4 years, how we lost in Norway in the opening international, drew in Denmark, lost to the Danes here, and then struggled to get a goal past East Germany. This is markedly better. 10 minutes from half-time and England leading by 1-0. Right. Robson. Linica starts going forward. Waddle in the hanging back position on the right side. Cross or shot, only he would know. Goriano, who supplied the face to comment on the pass. Reed. By Gary Lineker. A Villa. Stefanescu. More by three in the England half. Stefanescu. A lot made of it. Dare one tell Stefanescu that not too many in the crowd will believe that he's terribly hurt. Glenn Hoddle, not exactly noted for clattering people, although he was booked against Chelsea for a clattering tackle a bit earlier in the season. Stefanescu coming inside. And Hoddle with the hip. Haji. Very obvious pass. Rednik. Villa. Baronet hasn't really been able to get into the game. Haji. Klein. Kamataru getting himself in front of Wright, I think for the first time. Fielding making sure that everybody's concentration matches his. Wright's header. Haji. Rednik. Haitley. Not perhaps the moment to do that. Clinic showing Haitley what a defender would do in that situation. Ungurianu. Fair challenge. Hoddle. Real anticipation in the crowd. Want to see England cement the lead. Minutes to go to half time. One header by Wright. Quite a long way to make it. Three waiting for the cross. Wright once more. Hoddle. Everything to his right. Klein, Haji making the forward run. Well stopped by Fennec. Robson, Reed. Waddle. And how about another goal before half-time? Corner. A bit hasty two or three times in attacking positions, Gary Stevens. Right. Unlucky. Villa. strikes across. Right catching it on the chin. Hadji on the back of the head. A very competitive little run by the Romanian. Full of pace and intent. And Shilton against Kamataru. And the goalkeeper fouled. The question surely needs to be asked as to why the goalkeeper found himself with absolutely nobody between him and Kamataru. Kamataru pulls away here from Haitley, who's looking at the ball, totally lost where Kamataru's gone, and the centre forward could well have made England pay for that. Jovan immediately goes off to search for Haitley. Didn't look too confident then, Lund. And the referee does not give a free kick. That has obviously worried Long. Right. Benick. The last of the first 45 minutes. Lineker, Fennec, Waddle wasn't moving for the ball inside the back, which is a pity. He's got a corner. Not confidently away, Reed. At all, whatever he does, Peter Reid, his expression is that of a man who seems to have just woken up. Benick, handball by Kamataru. Stefanescu, Godianu, strange ball by him. Stefanescu, right, a particularly good header. Koresh. Koresh, presumably asking him why he didn't score. It's the last action of the half. England lead by 1-0, scored by Glenn Hoddle in the 25th minute. That in itself will satisfy Bobby Robson, who must feel so far so good. He must also be impressed by the performance of Peter Reid. But Hadji has hit the woodwork twice, the crossbar at the start, and this fine run at the end, the ball played through the legs of Stevens. Hadji got away from right, tried to chip Peter Shilton, and the angle of post and crossbar kept England's lead. He goes off with a lot to think about. Certainly given England a lot to think about. think the greatest summary of the player's ability is the fact that he obviously believes he should have scored, and he's getting some applause as he goes down the tunnel. Questioning the entertainment value so far, and the statistics of goal attempts make interesting reading. England had 6, scored with 1, 2 were saved and 3 were off target in the first half. And Romania had 5, 2 hit the woodwork, 1 was saved, 1 was blocked and the other 1 was off target. So for all the greater possession that England had, if Romania had a little bit more luck, they could be leading 2-1. Klein. And there's the England bench, and we think still wondering about pace against our defence. Reid. Robson. Lineker got away and was pulled a bit, I thought. And Reid is hurt out on the touchline. Hatley, the flag is up, the flag is up. But I think Reid is in serious trouble. Seems to me to have pulled a muscle. Free kick given to Romania. Well, not as bad as I feared. But a marked difference between the attitude of two injured players. Reid comes back pretty quickly. Koresh requires the physio, the doctor and the manager to be on their feet. And maybe the coach driver as well, I'm not sure. Bobby Robson's usual ploy of coming down on the bench in the second half. Something he used to do at Ipswich quite often too. Here's Jovan. Line. Foul by Kamataru. Oh, Brian Robson. Romania yet to lose in England. 3-1-1 here in January 69, 0-0 in April 81. Hatley! The free kick has been given against him. And the West German referee having a few words. Thank you. he makes his case with the official. The danger has now passed. It was one against one then, had Waddle got away, he was in with a chance of a shot. Stevens cross. Waddle's taken a knock on the thigh that's still hurting him. Stevens, Lineker onside. Corner. Clay Wilkins, the only midfield player on the England bench. We still feeling his knock. Wright's usual position. Fenwick just inside the six-yard area, square of him. Robson, oh, that's a comfortable play. The goalkeeper, who seemed rather surprised about it. Worked neatly enough. Robson. Waddle. Sanson on the outside. Waddle had two good attacks on the outside of his man in the first half. Robson. Right. Sansom. Of the match so far, and the crowd endeavouring to change that. Lineker. Neither he nor Stefanescu pull out of that. Peter Shilton asking for it. Reed moving a bit better now. Fenwick is the back man. Can't huddle very well indeed. Robson cut out by Rednick. Arrogant, confident pass from right. Reed. Waddle, take him on the outside, doesn't want to. Waddle again. And it's across the line at the moment. There are plenty of reds in the line. Certainly had belief in the England team. Ivan protesting innocence again. Huddle, Sanson screaming at him. Oh. Waddle. Shilton was a lonely figure in the half until Wright moved into it. Robson well forward. Lineker. Goodwell. Reed. Stevens on the overlap. Touch of the Evertons together then. But in a way, Brian Robson was slightly in the way, really. Made it more difficult for Stevens. Has to go at a faster pace than he wanted, I think. Couldn't balance himself before crossing. Right, a push from Kamataru. Corne. India. Stefanescu. Ungureanu. England will be quite happy if they played the ball around in this area of the field. Taru forward with two others. Ball is out of play. Reed. Maggi. Koras. Now Waddle. It's going to be close. Oh, unlucky. No, he's been allowed to go on. Well, I've no doubt in my mind that the ball was over the line. Just watching. Stevens. Reed. Just have a feeling that the second one is not far away. Lineker. Well, one has to say that action by Jovan was exactly the same sort of handball instinctive reaction that cost Philip so much last night at Ninian Park. Three in the six-yard area. Right. Waddle again. Waddle. Still four waiting, far post. That's too close to the goalkeeper. Rednik. Aguila. Bellany. None of the probing passes from him that were seen in Bucharest. The Romanian midfield was very much more progressive than England's. The reverse has been true here this evening. Waddle. Waddle into space, Bellanet coming in. Lovely turn, and the shirt stood the test. Reed. On for Rinica, trying to get in the back. Good defensive play by Stefanescu. It's a good player, Stefanescu. He's just set to create a new appearance record in the Romanian league. In the figure of Cornel Dinu, one of the players who played against us in the 70 World Cup. Korash. Huddle. He's clear, is Lineker. Referee says no foul. That's so nearly. I think the best thing about that was really not so much the pass, which just didn't quite come off, but the fact that he saw it so quickly, having won the ball. The pace of Lineker was a trailing factor. Kamataru, did he take it with his hand? Shilton, it's one apiece. Shilton obviously thought that he used his hand. Look at Francescu there. Good heavens, what's this? But I must say, I thought the number 9 used his hand. With a flick on by Rednik. Surely there was a touch of the forearm there. But he got right through the heart of the England defence. Peter Shilton to meet him. And Shilton, in fact, went the wrong way. He's guided past his legs by Kamataru. And Peter Shilton's clean sheet is spoiled. And so is England's possession. Hour of the match, and it's 1-1. Result not good for Bobby Robson if it stays that way, or indeed for Billy Bingham. Been so much on top in the second half. Ungureanu. Morash is in the middle. He's the man who got the goal. Kamataru. Puddle. It's a little blind, but it worked. Bennett got himself lost and was given the ball back. Robson. Very well done by the England skipper. Waddle. Good play by the goalkeeper and a full pressure. Murphy says that was chest as well by Hadji. Stevens. Waddle. Kamataru. Hadji. The read comes goal side. He's still feeling that knock there. Korash. Determined Terry Fenwick. So much wants his place in this side. Stefanescu. Fenwick. And nobody bothers to chase it. Huddle. Trying to chest it for Waddle. Huddle. Reed. Haitley. Lineker. what he was doing. Reed's cross, won by Robson, on by Hatley, little touch from Lineker, but really Stevens didn't get over the ball, he was leaning back. Oh, good header, Fenwick. Rednick. Korash. Too long for Hadji. Fenwick. Huddle. Making his sixth consecutive appearance for England. Although by no means all of them have been for the full 90 minutes. Here's Reed. Found an extra gear. Robson. Stevens on the right. Robson. Waddle. To come inside his man again, and that was simply going back into the rush hour. And here's Hadji. Sanson off in chase to get the correct side of him. Avia, early ball looking for Kamataru. Reed. Stevens. Right. England, of course, with Turkey and Northern Ireland to come here to get the points needed to qualify for Mexico. But it would do so much for football generally for them to make sure of that place tonight. And the crowd just showing signs of losing patience. Quickly the good things can be forgotten. Romania really have had one attack in this half and they score from it. Stefanescu. Free kick against Hadji. John Barnes is a substitute warming up. Fenwick. Huddle. Rednick just concerned to clear it. Stevens. Halfway through the second half. England 1, Romania 1. England never beaten at home in a World Cup match. Romania haven't been beaten here. Sanson. Lindy away from Hadji. Lineker, good save. Lineker disappointed. Scored six times this season, Gary Lineker, for his new club. Curiously, five of them with his head. What a lovely piece of play by Kenny Sansom. All swivel hips, all neat control. Played it off as he was moving on to the other foot. Well struck and well saved. Kamataru in chase. Fenwick battling well. Stevens. Reed. Sanson going forward. Kamataru has gone with him. Trying to get Sanson in again. delayed for the introduction of John Barnes. And he replaces Chris Waddle. So it's a swap which has become quite common, one way around or the other. And John Barnes has been given time to make his presence felt. 20 minutes remaining. Well won by Stevens. And here's little Hunty again. And he's beaten by little Sanson. Barnes facing Naguila, who forces him inside. Easy for a winger to get outside. Nice turn by Huddle. Good recovery by Unguriano. Hatley. Two to mark him. Right. Reed. Leung has come a long way and justified his inclusion. Been pretty confident in the air. They didn't like the way he was shaken up by Hatley in the first half, particularly when the referee didn't give a free kick. England here faced by an old problem. How to break down a side that are concerned just about only with defence. Lineker. Huddle. And we're looking to him to find the right ball. Not there. Sanson. Barnes needing the moments to settle into the game. He's seen the ball quite a lot since he came on. Right. Stevens. Reed. Oh, he just couldn't get the touch as he could. Corner. Well, that's one way of doing it. Being prepared to go for the throat. If he'd been able to push the ball wide to Barnes then, that could have been very interesting. Brian Robson. Korach just attacked the player. Stevens. Well played. It's spread out a bit. Lineker. It's a goal kick. No width at all then on that England attack. Stevens was trying to go through the middle and he had to beat friend and foe alike. Huddle. On come England again. Reed. Barnes. Right. It really is an encampment. The only part which belongs to Romania. bit for Brian Robertson. His determination took him on. Heathley. Off your back. Few minutes left. Still certainly a match to be enjoyed. The hope of victory, the fear of a breakaway. That could finish this completely. Let's hope not. Another corner. Romanian so far withstanding the pressure and confirming the impression they gave in the last European Championships. All the fact that they failed to win a game suggested they were a coming side. There's more individual ability here than in many of their sides of the past. John Barnes. Lineker. I don't know about you, but my mind is going back to that night against Poland. When the ball just wouldn't go in. Another set of red shirts buying the way here. Santam. Certainly one of the contenders for man of the match, can he sense him? Huddle out guess by Belenic. Foul by Reid. This is a part of the remaining game we could well do without. I don't know whether the trainer or doctor gets appearance money, but he's certainly very keen to get off the bench and on the field. But the referee will have none of it. And good for him. Blatant time wasting. He's shown to Stefanescu, the Romanian skipper. Not that that is of any help to England. Right, Koresh jumped at the player. Referee allowed play to continue, but had a quick word with Koresh. This is Fenwick. Sanson. Lineker. Been a bit unlucky, Lineker. It hasn't always landed well for him. Mark Wright. Heathley. Right. Stevens. struggling to get hold of the ball. And Romanians have four in attack here. And this one is Hadji. Kamataru waiting in the middle. Kouraish on the edge of the box. Klein just outside the area. No danger there. Tony Woodcock on his feet, as is Romulus Gabor. Robson. Sanson. Barnes. Struck in by Nagula. To make their second substitution. Gary Lineker who goes off. And Tony Woodcock, who missed the summer tour, comes back to the England seat. England's top scorer in the current squad. 16 he has. That's too long. And he's well played. Can open the door. Robson. Barnes. Too long. And Romania to make their substitution, and what an interesting one by Mircea Lucescu. He's pulling off Kouraș and putting on a man who, like the coach himself, is a winger. Kouraș not keen to depart, substituted for the second time in matches against England. And this time, he hasn't missed the sitter. Gabor plays for Corvinul, where Lucescu used to coach. A real up and under and nothing more. And they've lost their pattern a little, not too surprisingly. It was a real snap in the face, the goal from the one attack. That gives Romania the chance of three draws out of three in England. It would greatly improve their chances of making it to Mexico. Really, that's much worse for Northern Ireland than it is for England. Right. Robson. Sanson. Hodder. Robson, space on the right with Stevens. Woodcock moving from the penalty spot. But the high crosses are too often from the wrong angle. Haven't been pulled back from the goal line. Reed. Woodcock, Stevens, Haitley, hasn't really managed to make a header of any great note. England have 5 minutes to get the second goal. I suppose one has to say it, 5 minutes to prevent Romania doing precisely that too. Here's Hadji. He might have had two for himself. It's possession stuff from the Romanians. Hadji, Kamataru, Gabor waiting in the middle. Rednik, Sansa. Free kick for the challenge from Gabor. Robson. Intended, well killed by Woodcock. Buns. Well, that helped England. Buns. And still. Robson. Almost too many feet. Left, the reaction to that pass was understandable. Huddle. Yes! Buns! Yes! No! The flag is up on the far side. Well, I can only think the flag was for offside. Must have been very, very tight indeed. Well, level would be enough. What a pity. And Klein is coming off to be replaced by Matsiut. Showing his disappointment, seemed to be the most incisive move that England had made in the entire evening. Because the goal, one had to remember, came from a set piece and meant in open play. Sansa hasn't given too many away. Meguia. Not a good ball by Robson. Really didn't look as though he wanted it. Huddle, nobody left side, so he has to turn. Barnes again, starting to wander, and looks much happier when he's allowed to do that. His manager feels he's a better player when he's allowed to do that. 1-1 it is. And Mircea Lucescu greets that as a victory, which for him it is, to get a point here at Wembley. The goal scored by Kamataru from the only attack of note that Romania had in the second half. But it has to remember that Hagi twice hit the post. And England's goal, which was equalised by Kamataru, scored by Glenn Hoddle in the 25th minute. The goal was in the 25th minute and in the 60th minute. And I think the match could best be summarised by saying that the performance shows that we are good enough to go to Mexico, but there is work to be done if we are to make a real impression there. But there is promise. What a contrast on the faces of the two managers. Lucescu wants the Romanian players back to take a bow. Now, hang on, the doctor's got to get into the photograph, or the physio. Now, here's a test for you. Who is this man? The big fellow at the back there. Well, Gordon Banks would know him well. He's a goalkeeper who played against us in 1970, Nicolae Raducanu. I'll tell you what, to be picked up by him is to put one's life in danger. If you'd have seen him kicking a ball here at Wembley last night, you'd have thought for all the world that he was an ex-centre forward. Does strike it so well. So, the position of qualification as far as Lucescu is concerned, in his own hands, because Northern Ireland still have to go to Bucharest. Stefanescu, once more, a successful skipper against England.
Here.
Right. I think if you want to get your brownie out and nip around, you've got time.